Flows are a great way to construct a sequence of operations to prepare your data in SAS Studio. If you have access to SAS Studio, I encourage you to follow along with me. Your environment may already have the files used in this demo. However, if you don't see them, please visit our SAS Software GitHub page. The SAS Viya Quick Start repository provides the files used in our demonstrations and instructions to load them into your environment. You can open SAS Studio from the Applications menu by selecting Develop Code and Flows. Let's open a completed flow. I'll navigate to Files, Data, Quick Start, and double-click Prepare Home Equity Data.flw. This flow has several different components that execute SAS and Python programs, compute new columns and update labels, join tables, export files, generate reports, and provide documentation with notes. In the Steps pane, you'll find a list of useful steps that you can add to a flow. This list grows with each new release, but my favorite part of SAS Studio is the ability to create your own custom steps. In the Shared tab, we see a custom step named Print Sample. If you would like to learn how to create this Print Sample step, watch and follow along with the Create Custom Steps with SAS Studio Quick Start video. We'll use this step later when we recreate this flow. Notice that our flow is organized into multiple sections, or swim lanes. Swim lanes group and sequence the execution of the nodes. The properties of each node can be accessed in the bottom portion of the screen. For example, I'll click the loanCustomer.xlsx file node and then click the Restore Preview icon. I'll open the file location and confirm the file will be saved in the Quick Start folder. I'll type loan customers in the name field, change the type to Microsoft Excel, and then click Save. I'll minimize the preview to view the complete flow. I can run nodes individually, run a selected swim lane, or run the entire flow. I'll click Run. As the steps execute successfully, you'll see a green checkmark appear on each icon. Select Submitted Code and Results to view the code, log, output data, and results. Let's start from scratch and recreate the contents of the Prepare Home Equity Data swim lane. First, I'll clean up the workspace by right-clicking any of the tabs and selecting Close All. I don't need to save any of the changes I've made. I'll click Build a Flow. I could also add a new tab and select Flow. I'll drag the Import Home Equity program into the flow. A SAS program node appears, and I can see the associated program on the Code tab. I could also use the SAS program step to either reference a SAS program file or copy the code directly in the node. Because this node is the start of my flow, I'll right-click the icon and select Remove Input Port. The program generates the home equity table, so I'll go to the Steps pane, drag the table step to the flow, and then connect it to the output port of my program node. In the lower half of the window, I'll customize the node properties. I'll select the work library and the home equity table. I'll run the flow to execute the program and link the corresponding table. Next, I'll connect the Calculate Column step to the Table node. I'll select City, which happens to be a column stored in all lowercase. If I click Define, I can apply a variety of transformations to modify the data values. I'll select Change Case and Proper Case. The updated column values will be replaced in the City column. I can click New and create a column based on an expression. This column will be the mortgage due divided by the value of the property. The name of the column will be LTV, and the label will be loan to value ratio. The type is numeric, and the format is percent. I'll click Save, and then run the step to confirm that it executes successfully. Another useful step is the query. I want to join the result of the Calculate column step with a table named US Data from the SAS Help library. This will enable us to include population data from the origin state for each loan. I'll drag US Data into the flow and then add the query step to the Calculate column's output port. If I right-click Query, I can add an input port and then connect US Data as another data source. I like to use the Arrange Nodes button or drag the nodes to optimize the layout. In the query details, I'll add all columns from the T1 table, which is the table created from the Calculate column step. And I'll add the Population 2020 column from US Data. I'll update the label to replace the underscore with a space. On the Join tab, I can specify the join columns as state from T1 and state name from T2 or US Data. I'll also change the join type to a left join to include all the rows from the T1 table in the result. Let's use the Node tab to rename the query as Join Pop Data in the flow. I'll drag a table node to the flow and connect it to the output port of the query step. In the table properties, I'll specify that the output table should be saved to the work library as Home Equity Final. Let's run the query node to create the new table. Finally, let's use the custom step, Print Sample, to generate a report for the Home Equity Final table. If you don't see the Print Sample step in the Shared tab, use the Print Sample Final.step file in the Quick Start folder. I'll connect the Print Sample step and customize the properties. Note that I don't have an option to select the input table because the data source is determined from the flow. I'll display all columns and print the first 10 rows. Let's test the complete flow. We can reset the SAS session under the Options menu to delete all temporary tables and ensure that the flow runs as expected. Now with a new session, I'll click Run. I see all green check marks, which looks great. Under Submitted Code and Results Output Data, I can view all tables created from nodes in the flow, as well as temporary tables that are built between nodes. What if I'd like the final output table to be an in-memory table that can be analyzed in my other applications, such as SAS Visual Analytics or Model Studio? Our data must be loaded into memory in SAS Cloud Analytics Services, or CAS. To make this happen, my output location must be a CAS lib. I'll return to the Home Equity Final node and select CAS User as the output library. Under the Options tab, I'll select Promote to a Global In-Memory Table, which means that the table will persist in memory and be available in the other SAS Viya applications. I'll also select the option to save the table on disk and replace either version if it exists. Let's run the flow one more time. Once it's complete, I can go to the Libraries pane and see that the in-memory table, Home Equity Final, is available in the CAS user CASLib. I could access it in SAS Visual Analytics to create interactive and exploratory reports, or build a model in Model Studio to predict loan success or default. To finalize the flow, I'll select Add, Note, and add text to document that the Home Equity Final table is loaded into memory. I'll click Save, navigate to my folder, and save the flow as My Home Equity Flow. We've just scratched the surface of what is possible with SAS Studio Flows. If you would like to learn more, please visit the Learning Center to discover additional resources.